The upcoming Flight 9 mission is a pivotal moment for SpaceX in the wider aerospace sector, marking a significant step forward. In order to be successful, it is essential that all systems, especially Starship S35, are in optimal condition. There are a number of challenges that have emerged since the transition to version 2, which must be overcome. Additionally, SpaceX team morale remains critical as the pressure on Elon Musk to provide direction and leadership increases. So how will SpaceX overcome these obstacles as they eye Flight 9? Let's dive deeper in today's episode of NR Studio. As the countdown to Flight 9 continues, the anticipated launch date has unfortunately been pushed back to near the end of the month. This delay is primarily due to the rigorous preparation required for Starship hardware. Recently, Booster B14, despite being on the launch pad, had to return to the production facility for further evaluation. While the exact issue with B14 is still uncertain, it is likely related to the engine, lattice fins, or hot staging ring. Fortunately, this setback is not expected to take long to resolve. Additionally, because B14 was set to make an emergency landing at sea rather than a challenging landing attempt, it received less scrutiny than previous boosters. In contrast, S35 has been thrust into the spotlight after two recent mission failures. All eyes are on this latest iteration to restore confidence in the Starship program. The mission in the works will be far more complex. S35 must not only avoid the pitfalls encountered by ships 28 and 30, but also perform an in-space engine restart, complete a payload deployment task, and safely re-enter Earth's atmosphere using an upgraded cover and improved heat shield. S35 has now been transported to the Massey test site for the third time, a move anticipated following the announcement of road closures on May 21st from noon to p.m. and again from 10 p.m. to a.m. on the 22nd. The transport was preceded by signs indicating that significant testing was coming, including an engine swap. One engine was undocked from Mega Bay 2 weeks ago, with new engines arriving on the evening of May 20th and the morning of May 21st. The static fire test carrier also appeared that same morning, confirming that the S35 was being prepared for its third static fire assessment. Successful completion of the static fire test this week could keep the dream of a late May launch alive. In preparation for this mission, the S35 has undergone a more rigorous testing regimen than previous prototypes. Its cryogenic testing has included multiple rounds, likely using varying fuel levels to push the limits of the tank and determine any vulnerabilities. As Flight 9 approaches, the path ahead is both challenging and promising, with hopes of overcoming each obstacle to redefine what's possible in space exploration. In response to the recent liquid oxygen tank issue that led to the cancellation of Flight 8 launch attempt, SpaceX Starship S35 has undergone extensive preparation efforts. The vehicle has completed two initial rounds of static fire testing at the Massey facility. The first round featured a single-engine ignition, followed by a successful test involving all six engines. However, the second test experienced complications with one of the engine vacuums, requiring the S35 to return to Mega Bay 2 for repairs. The problematic engine was replaced, and the vehicle was prepared for another round of evaluation, which was ultimately successful. As the focus shifts to the upcoming third static fire test, it is clear that the S35 fuel system and engines have undergone rigorous scrutiny. However, the unusual frequency of testing and the vehicle's movements may indicate deeper concerns about the reliability of its performance under actual flight conditions. On a positive note, SpaceX has demonstrated its ability to quickly identify and correct issues. After returning from Massey, the S35 engine system will continue to be closely monitored. As we dive deeper into the engine's condition, it is important to note that many of the challenges stem from SpaceX's transition to the second version of the Starship design. The updated model eliminates some engine protection systems to reduce overall mass, increasing efficiency, but making the engines more vulnerable to damage, as seen during Flight 8 vacuum engine fire. In addition, modifications to the engine configuration have introduced new vulnerabilities, most notably a phenomenon known as harmonic response. This issue can cause sensitive components inside the engine and fuel lines to resonate destructively under certain conditions, potentially leading to cracks, leaks, or even fires. With these challenges in mind, anticipation for SpaceX's next maneuver is heightened. Flight 9 is no ordinary launch. It is a pivotal moment for the Starship program to demonstrate its progress and resilience. To succeed, SpaceX must effectively address the underlying issues that emerged during previous flights. While recent test results are promising, complacency is not an option. Ground testing, while important, cannot fully simulate the unpredictable nature of real-world flight. Both previous missions passed pre-launch testing but experienced significant failures in the air, underscoring that real-world performance is the ultimate benchmark. Beyond the short-term improvements made to the current V2 prototype, SpaceX also has substantial changes to consider. The transition to the V3 version of Starship will allow for more radical improvements to existing systems. Among the most significant upgrades is the implementation of the new Raptor 3 engines, paving the way for the next generation of SpaceX's ambitious space exploration goals. SpaceX unveiled a new engine that promises better thrust and reliability than previous versions. These advancements could address some of the persistent issues encountered in V2 flights, creating a more robust platform for future missions. It's important to note that the failures seen in the last two missions may not have been entirely due to the modifications made to V2. Some theories suggest that the booster's hot staging system may have played a role in the ship's malfunctions due to vibration resonance. To mitigate this, SpaceX made adjustments to the hot staging ring on Booster 14 in anticipation of Flight 9. However, for a lasting solution, the company is focused on implementing a redesigned hot staging configuration that was publicly unveiled last year. The new system is expected to be a fundamental aspect of Starship V3 design and operation. Turning our attention to Ship 35, in addition to the engine system improvements, SpaceX is actively addressing other technical challenges that have been identified. Improvements to the heat shield and shroud systems are part of the V2 evolution, with reports indicating that the heat shield tiles have undergone significant material upgrades. Some sections are now reinforced with multi-layered blades to better withstand re-entry conditions. In previous flights, SpaceX strategically left some tiles behind to test the capabilities of the new material and also introduced a small segment of the metallic heat shield for experimental evaluation. As for the cover, the obvious changes in design and positioning are aimed at optimizing aerodynamic control and thermal stability. However, unlike the engines, the newly designed heat shield and cover system have yet to demonstrate their effectiveness in a live mission. Therefore, it is critical that SpaceX closely monitors its performance. If Ship 35 successfully ascends without complications, the upgraded system will face its ultimate test during re-entry. The goal is for it to perform reliably under pressure, but regardless of the outcome, SpaceX must collect comprehensive data and remain ready to implement additional improvements. Moving forward, another critical area that requires SpaceX attention is the payload deployment system. This part of the mission is still untested, and even a small error during deployment could jeopardize the flight. Furthermore, there is a risk that complications could arise during the actual deployment process, requiring careful care in the installation and testing of the system to ensure that it does not adversely affect the overall success of the mission. Ultimately, after completing all testing, and once the hardware is back on the launch pad, efforts will focus on final preparations for the next phase of the mission. SpaceX should not ignore this wet dress rehearsal, WDR, especially considering the lessons learned from Flight 8. The WDR is a critical step to ensure that all systems, from fueling to countdown protocols, operate smoothly under launch conditions. It is the last chance to detect and fix any outstanding issues before launch. To date, the SpaceX team appears to have made significant strides in addressing the challenges that plagued the last two missions, particularly those related to the V2 design. Additionally, they are taking a more deliberate approach to preparing for new objectives that were not validated on previous flights. However, there is still much work to be done in the coming days to ensure that Flight 9 is a success. Do you believe SpaceX has addressed the Starship issues adequately? What additional steps do you think need to be taken? Feel free to share your thoughts in the comments below. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to stay up to date on SpaceX's incredible journey. However, SpaceX hurdles don't end with the technical fixes. Employee morale has emerged as another pressing issue, especially given Elon Musk's recent absence. Over the past year, Musk has devoted more time to his other ventures, resulting in a reduced presence at Starbase, which some team members say has negatively affected morale. According to Dylan Small, a Starbase employee, the team is giving it their all, but the atmosphere has changed. Morale is low, and people feel burned out and like they're being left behind. He highlighted how Musk's previous leadership galvanized and inspired the team, a feeling that now appears to be diminishing. Dylan urged Musk to come back, listen to his team, and rekindle their motivation. Additionally, internal sources have flagged deeper issues, including weakened leadership, poor decision-making, ignoring cost-saving ideas, increasing bureaucracy, a declining company culture, and ethical issues, all areas that require Musk's direct intervention. Fortunately, Musk addressed these issues on May 13th via his platform on X, stating, "I'll be there next week." He also announced a company meeting at Starbase ahead of Flight 9, where he would outline SpaceX's roadmap to Mars. While the focus of the meeting is Mars, it presents an important opportunity to address morale and operational issues head-on. Musk's leadership has often been debated, but his ability to inspire and unite teams has been integral to SpaceX's ethos and accomplishments. And his return comes at a crucial time. Flight 9 is a critical mission that could restore confidence after two challenging flights and set the stage for important milestones such as ship recovery, V3 upgrades, in-space refueling, and systems development for lunar and Mars missions. All eyes are now on Starbase. What changes will Musk implement after his return, and whether it will be a short visit or a long-term commitment? That's it for today's episode. See you in the next one, and thanks for your support.